Hey guys, welcome to the channel Unshackling Sudokus and Puzzles. Today I'll be solving a little killer Sudoku created by G. Reyners. We thank the author for allowing us to make a video on his Sudoku. The thing that appeared to me about the Sudoku was the placement of the clues. As you can see, all the clues are pointing towards the left. It's really a beautiful theme to have in a little killer Sudoku. The link to try the Sudoku out yourself is given in the description of the video. You can try it out yourself and please make sure to come back and watch the video. And the rules of the Sudoku are classic rules apply. And additionally, you have some little killer clues given outside the grid. So if you take some clue, for example 16, and the consider the direction pointed by the arrow, the sum of the digits in that direction will give us 16, and digits may repeat in the direction of the arrow. So for example, if you take this 31, one of these digits which is present here may also be here. So as long as classic rules are violated, digits may repeat. So these are the rules. Seems to be a really interesting one. We'll start the Sudoku. So 14 is here, which means that 14 can only be 5 plus 9 or it is 6 plus 8, only two possibilities. Then I'm going to 8. 8 can be 125 or 134, and both the cases will have a 1 in them, so I'm marking the 1 in that direction. I have a 32, I have a 19, 22, 31, 68, and a 16, which means that this has to be 7 and 9. No other possibility. 68 suddenly seems interesting to me because that is the highest valued clue in the entire grid. Let me check by substituting all the maximum values along this direction. Let us see what happens maybe. So this would be maximum 17, this is maximum 9, 8, 9, 9, that is a 9 max, and that is 8. So if I do that, how much is the value I'm going to get? 17 from here, plus 9 is 26, plus 17 is 43, plus 9 52, plus 17 is 69. Okay, awesome. So when I substituted the maximum values along this direction, I am getting a total one more than that, which means I have a degree of freedom of 1. And what that basically means is that from this box or from these cells, you lose 1 degree of freedom, which means that this is either 17 or the total is 16. From that is the case for all these cells along this direction. So similarly, this box will add up to 17 or 16, and similarly, this would be 17 or 16, this could be 8 or 9. So we can write the pencil marks. And if it's 16, this becomes 7, 8, 9, this could be 8 or 9, this could be 7, 8, 9. And this cannot be a 16, we know now, because you have a 16 here already, which means that this would have to be a 17, right? So that is 8 and that is 9, that gives us a 7 here. We are sure that each of the boxes will have only 1 degree of freedom, and even the cells. So which means this could be 16 or 17, 16 was ruled out, so this would have to be 17. And I can remove the 9 from here, which means 5 is not possible. 8 is removed from here, which means 6 is not possible. Okay. Okay, look at this 18 clue, guys. There is absolutely only one way to fill that, which is this way. All these cells along that direction. The boxes particularly will have to have minimum possible total, right? 6 plus 6 plus 6. This is the only possible way to reach 18. The minimum possible values, that gives you 18 here. And now the 11, can it help? So minimum I'll have a 9 from these cells. So which means that I cannot have a 3 here. That's not a 3. And I need to have a 4 in one of these cells, right? Because if I don't have a 4, I'll get a total more than 11. So which means that 4 has to be in one of those cells. And maximum I would have a 6. Okay, so this pencil mark would be 4, 5, 6. Can't have anything more than 6 there. So coming over to this side, this 32 seems very interesting to me, I don't know why. So what is the maximum possible value these two cells can take? So let me assume something. Let me think that 8 is 1 to 5. So to have maximum possible value from these cells, I need to have absolute minimum from these cells, right? So this would be minimum 3, 4. And now these two cells will add up to, you have a 14 here, you have an 8 here, you have a 7 here, which gives me 29. Which means that these two cells must sum up to 16. Maximum possible value from these cells is 16. Okay, let me try with the 1, 3, 4 now to see if that changes things. I don't think it would change. So if it is 1, 3, 4, this would be minimum 2 and 5. And now again, 8 plus 14 is 22 plus 7 is 29, and you'll have maximum 16 from these cells. So both the cases, the maximum possible value from these two cells is 16, which means that minimum from these two cells would be 16. So which means that this would be a 789 pencil mark, and that would be a 789 pencil mark. You can't have 9 here. That's not 9. And now I can't have a 7 here, because 7 plus 8 is 15 only. So that cannot be a 7. So that's 8 and 9. And these two cells would have to be 15 or 16, right? If you have 14 from these cells, there is no way to satisfy the 32 total. So this is either 15 or 16. If it is 15, it could be 7 plus 8. But 7 and 8 is immediately ruled out. So next value is 6 and 9. But 6 and 9 is also ruled out because of this pencil mark. So which means that this would have to be 16. And that means that would have to be 7, 9. Awesome, guys. A really nice logical sequence of digits to get us something. So which means that this would have to be a 6 now. That becomes 8. That becomes 7, and we know that these two cells will minimum sum up to 16. So that would be a 9 now. And that 7 gives a 9 here and a 7 here. And 7, 8, so which means that's a 9. That has to be 7 or 8. And if you look at this 9, it is giving us 8 here. And which means that along this direction, we have lost our 1 degree of freedom, right? So which means that the rest of the values would have to be absolute maximum, right? I somehow removed the 8 from here. I'm not sure how. So this would have to be 8. And these two cells will have to be 8 and 9. That would have to be a 9. And now if we add up the total, I think we should reach 68, right? 17 plus 9, 26 plus 17, 43, 51 plus 17. Yeah. So we are getting 68, and that clue is satisfied now. So a 9 is here. So this would be 9 and that would be 8. Using classic, I can get the 8 here, column 1, column 2, and row 5. Nine must be in one of these two cells. 8 must be in one of these two cells. 8 must be in one of these two cells. All classic, guys. The next biggest question is, which clue to look at? Okay, let us look at the highest clue after the 68. So if I come along this direction, 65 is the highest clue, and it is scalping actually, because we have 4 digits already placed. So let me continue writing the maximum digits, 7. This would be maximum 9. This would be maximum 8, 9. So 17 plus 9 is 26, plus 15, 41, plus 8, 49, plus 17. 49 plus 17, how much is that? 59, 66. So I'm getting 66 now. Again, 1 degree of freedom. Awesome. So which means that this would have to be 6 or 7. That has to be 8 or 9. And these two cells would have to sum up to 17 or 16. So they would be 7, 8, 9. Nice. So I can use the pencil marks now to, candidates now to remove something. So this is 8, which means that's, this is 9. That's not a 7. And that's not even 8. So that is a 9. And which means this has to be 7 or 8. Okay. So I have to remember that there is exactly 1 degree of freedom along this direction. Okay. So using classic, I get the 9 here. So it's time to move on to the next highest clue. Maybe this 55 would help us. Again, I'm going to write the maximum possible digits. This is maximum 8 and 7. This would be maximum 8. This would be maximum 7, maximum 7. So if I add all these digits, 13 plus 7, 29 plus 7, 36, 44 plus 15, 59. Okay, I have lots of degrees of freedom, 4 degrees of freedom actually. So we could write some pencil marks exhaustively there, but I do not want to do that because definitely the author would have, there are so many clues here, there would be something even more sharper for sure. So going along this direction, 52 seems interesting, but there is nothing along that for. However, you have 8 nines along this direction, maybe this would help. So let me try writing out the maximum values. This would be maximum 13. This would be maximum 6 because of the 7, 8, 9. This would be again maximum 13, maximum 7, and again 6. So if I add these, I have 13 here, 13 here, 13 here. So 3 sets of 13, which is 39, and then plus 6, 45, and then plus 7, 52. Awesome, guys. Superb. Really, when we substituted maximum values, we are getting reaching 52. So which means that all these values would have to be absolute maximum. Now you have 7 here, so that means that is 6, that is 7, and these two cells are 4, 5, classic, and I have 14 here, and which means for the 18 clue, this would be 1, 2, 3, and that would be 1, 2, 3, so which means both of these cells sum up to 2, or both of those cells sum up to, both of those cells must be 2, or both those cells must be 1 and 3, okay. I have a 6 here, which means that's not 6, that's not 6. So 4, 5. So that becomes 2. No 2 here. Okay. This is nice, guys. So if I have a 1 here, then both of these cells must be 2 plus 2, right? No other possibility. And similarly, if I have a 3 here, 1 and 3 is again ruled out. So again it would be 2 and 2. So regardless of whether this is 1 or 3, the only possible way to get 18 along this direction is if you have 2 and 2 here. That's nice. So that's 1 and 3. Okay, using classic I can get a 6 here, right? So often it's important to use classic also in little killer Sudokus. We tend to forget using classic that the Sudoku can be continuous using classic too. So that is column 2, column 3 is 6, so which means that would be a 6. That gives 7 here and a 6 here. Superb, guys. Now I have lost my 1 degree of freedom along this direction. So which means that if I'm not wrong, this would have to be 8. And you can check it out, this would be summing up to 65, right? Only with the 8 here. Yes, these clues are summing up to 65. So we are on the right track, so that gives us an 8 here. And using classic, I can get the 7 here. And that gives a 7 here, so I placed all the 7s, okay, this one. All the 8s, that one. So I got all the 8s now. And all the 6s too, I think we can get. So all the 6s, so I'll get all the 6s. Okay, so all the 6s have been obtained. So that should make our task easier now. So the next clue to look at, let me look which one is severely constrained for now. I'm sure there would be a clue which would be really weak. Okay, look at this one, guys. We have got 4 along this direction. 9 plus 8 is 17 plus 6, 23 plus 8, 31. So maximum values from these cells is a 5. So this would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, as of now, I'm not able to reduce that further. But I know for certain these two cells must sum up to 6. Okay, so I'm going to continue further. This is done. This doesn't seem to be interesting. Okay, this would be 4, 5, and that would be 4, 5. Six plus 7, 13, 7 plus 9, 16, 16 plus 13 is 29. So these both cells would have to be 1. Superb. So we got digits now. Both would be 1, which means that this would be 3, 4, 5. All these would be 3, 4, 5. These would be 3, 4, 5. That would be a 3, 4, 5. And I remove the 1 from here. So that's 2 or 3. 1 is removed from here. 1 is removed from here. Which means I know that these two cells add up to 5. 6. So which means 5 can be removed from here, because 1 got removed. You can't have 1 in the other cell, so 5 got removed. Okay. So the big question is, which clue is really interesting to us here, right? Okay, this is interesting for sure. 7 plus 9 is 16 plus 3 is 19. So both of these cells sum up to 5. So this is 2 plus 3, 3 plus 2 or 4 plus 1. So that's 1, 2 and 3. Okay. Okay, this clue is interesting. Look at this, guys. So I was just scanning along the clues and the directions as well to see which one would be really helpful. 6 plus 8 is 14 plus 3 is 17. So these two again sum up to 5. So that's 3, 2, 1. Okay, this is also interesting, guys. Look at this clue. We got 13 already. So which means these three cells will add up to 6. And which means I cannot have a 5 here, because the total would be more than 6 then. So that's not a 5. So that's 3 or 4, which means these two cells will be severely constrained. If that's a 4, both of these cells will be strictly 1. And if that is the 3, then both these cells will sum up to 3, which means that this would be 1 and 2. Okay, so these are the possibilities here. That is really nice. And is that helping us? Yeah. So we have a 2 here, which means this would have to be a 1. Superb. So and that one gives a 3 here, a 2 here and a 1 here. Really nice, guys. Superb. So that's not a 3, that's 4, 5. And that is not a 3, that's 4, 5. That's not a 1, which means these two cells must be 2, 3 pair for the 22 clue. And these would be 4, 5. That's okay, you have a 2 here. So that's 3, that is 2. That's not 3, so you get 4, 5 from here. That is a 3 now. That's not 3, that's 4, 5. So it is really difficult to create Sudokus of this kind, guys. Especially, one thing is that you need to have great control while creating such Sudokus, because often you tend to have either a broken Sudoku because of so many clues, or you may have lots of redundant clues here. But I don't think we have any redundant clues here. All the clues are beautifully helping us continue the Sudoku. So a really nice construction. This 3 removes the 3 from here. That would be a 2 now for the row, which means that's 1, 3 pair. And using this clue, we can fill this column, fill this direction now. 16, 22, 25, 34. So that would have to be a 3. And for this 24 clue, this would have to be a 2 if I'm not wrong. 5, 12, 21 plus 3, 24. Yeah, that's right. That 3 removes the 3 from here. So 4, 5 pair. So that gives 3 here. That would be 4, 5. That has to be a 1. That would be a 4, 5. That is really nice. So this bigger clue is done. This bigger is done. This big clue is done. And this... Ooh, look at this, guys. All are 4, 5s in this direction. Is that something we need to use? If I'm putting maximum values along this direction, 5, 5, 5, I get 15 from here, and both of these boxes will give me 18, 9 plus 9, which means 15 plus 18, 33. Okay, so I have a degree of freedom of 1 along this direction. That is interesting to know. Although I'm not certain how to use that. What do I look for here? This 28 maybe, look at this 28, guys. So if I have 5, 5 here. Okay, I cannot have both of these cells as 5, right? Because if both these cells are 5, then I don't have space for a 5 in box 5. If this is a 5, this becomes 5 and this would have to be a 4. And similarly, if this is a 5, this becomes 5 and this would have to be a 4. So there is no way possible for both of these cells to be 5. So in fact, they must sum up to 9. So 9 plus 9 is 18 plus 7 is 25. I need 3 more. So this would be a 3. Right. So that would be a 1. And this would be 3, 4, 5. That would be 3, 4, 5 for the column. Am I missing something very simple here? Okay. This 19 clue can be filled, guys. 8 plus 9 is 17, so which means that this would be a 2. And which means that the 8 is now 134. It cannot be 125, so it is 134. So that cell has to be 4. That cell has to be 1 or 3, so that would be 3. That would be 1. That would be 5. And now we've got the 5, guys. Now look how the 4, 5 spread like wildfire. Really, literally like wildfire, guys. That becomes 4, that becomes 5, 4, 5, 4, 5, 4, 5, 4, 5, 4, 5, 5, 4, 5. Wildfire. Superb, superb, superb Sudoku, guys. Awesome. Just this one little digit here set us along the track. Superb one. So that is a 3 now, that is a 1 now. 5, 6, 7, 9, 1, 4, 8. So which means 2 and 3. So that is a 3, that is a 2. And that would have to be a 4 now, and that has to be 1. And with that, we have completed this gorgeous construction. At last, we'll maybe try to look at this 33 clue. 11, that would be 11, 22. 22 plus 11 is 33, right? So we have completed the Sudoku, guys. An awesome creation by Rainiers. Thank you, Rainiers, for really allowing us to make a video on the Sudoku. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. Please subscribe to the channel, guys. Please subscribe to the channel. It will be a big source of motivation for us. We would appreciate if you really help us grow as a channel so that we can sustain in the same. So thank you for watching. We hope to see you soon with a video. Bye-bye.